Okay, so here's my finished dovetail pieces that I am getting ready to mark and cut into the ends here. But before I do that, I'm going to need some type of reference. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to reference off of this back edge. And to reference off that back edge, I need to trim this to the same angle as this. Move this over just a little bit. And then I'm going to go look at my piece again. That's why you always leave a little extra and just sneak up on your final dimension. I'm getting ready to mark my first where my tails are going to go down into my 20 degree, 17 and a half is what it really worked out to be, 17 and a half degree angled end. Now, I don't want to try to fight this thing, and this piece, since it's since it's much wider than it is longer, it's got a little bit of a cup in it that I need to account for. So I've got this clamp to this straight board. It's actually the one that I used to chop the dovetails. And now I've got this clamp to this, and I've got everything kind of pinned and lined up, and I can see that everything just looks really pretty perfect. I'm going to tap this just a little bit right here. Just feel that. That's better. And just making sure that everything is lining up just the way I think it should. My bottom angle is perfect. That joint looks perfect. And so I'm going to take my favorite marking knife, which is just a paring knife that I put a sharp edge on. And I don't have to do much. Actually, the more crazy you get, the less accurate your line is. I see I got a little spot in here that I didn't fully clean out. So all I need to do is just give myself a line just to get my Japanese saw started. And I generally do all the tops like this. I think I can take this off now. Yeah, I can take that off because these clamps are holding that. That was just to get it in position. And you can see I cut my tails about a half a millimeter too long. I'd rather leave them a little long than be too short. So all I have to do is just pare them off or hit them with the belt sander or block plane. But back to what I was saying before, if you can scribe it, if you can mark it, you can cut to that mark. Now, if you try to wing it without marking it, that's where you get into trouble. But if you put a scribed mark on a piece of wood, and you either cut with a Japanese saw or pare it to there with a chisel or a plane, you can make perfect joints. Well, I'll say it again. I think that if you can scribe a line, an accurate line, you can cut to that accurate line and then finish, if you need to, paring it with a sharp knife, a chisel, and you can make pretty darn perfect joints. So, you know, these were what I marked here. These are what I marked right here, actually with the actual tails of the pieces that I had cut on the table saw. And then I just followed the line down and to the depth that I needed it, and then of course I used my my marking gauge and created the depth here. And I remember I didn't get into my area where I'm going to show that scribe line, which I don't like to do. So I'm ready to cut these. I'm gonna cut down in here with the Japanese saw, and then I'm gonna waste this out again with the coping saw. And then I'll just trim it, and then it should dry fit together. Then the next thing after that is I'll figure out how to put my sliding dovetails, what dimension to put those in. Well, this just shows you the versatility of my work table that I have here. So I've got the bottom of my panel clamped to that drawer, so I can pull it out and bring it exactly plumb with whatever I'm working on, and that thing is so heavy it doesn't move. And then I've got my mahogany rabbeted piece that I use for all kinds of clamping fixtures. I've got it clamped to the table, and then here is the top of my piece, and I've got that leveled off at the top. I just have a hard time trying to cut down very plumb and accurate if the board is laying down, especially since the tails have that 10 degree angle on them. So I just prefer to cut them while the piece is standing up. So that's what I'm going to do. And of course I can just walk up onto my table on the back side of this by that other drawer that I have pushed through. So let me just go up and do it. So I'm using my it's got the frame on the back, the stiffening frame on the back, but this is a rip saw. But I want to cut to the inside of my line. Alright, let me show you how I waste this material after I've cut this out. So I just take a quarter inch drill bit, and this is the inside of the cabinet, so the dovetails are coming up like this. I don't want to go the other way in case I bust through, so I know that the angle's running down like that, so I have plenty to shoot into. And I don't want to get too close. I just want to waste some material here. Kind of angling it that way to make sure that I'm not going to cut into the portion that I want to keep. And I mean, I could do this with a jigsaw, but you know me, I'm a hand tool guy in a lot of ways. So I'll just use my big coarse Japanese rip saw here. And I'll just give myself a place for that ripping saw to get into. Know if I could do it much faster with a jigsaw than this either. A lot of these I'll just break them out. I'm not 100% positive that I've cut, and I don't want to cut into the side shoulder here to free it. So I'll do that on the other side too, but you know, here, since I see that I I left my mark short here, so I'm gonna go ahead and come in here, and I can kind of come a little closer to my mark, and that's gonna help me get rid of that waste too. I need to do that anyway. It's hard to do it in the vertical, plus, you know, you don't want to cut into it if you don't have to. Well, you don't want to, definitely, because it's going to show. So what I'm saying here is, you know, I'll still leave this short, and I'll just come back in here with a chisel and a hammer, and I'll just break this out so I can really see what I'm doing. I don't want to waste this and cut into the sides of my piece yet. You know, I don't want to make a mistake.